Hello. Just checking to make sure everything's running all right, so give me one second. Okay. All right. Hello. I was just waiting for an upload to finish just now. But welcome to part 7 of the Sith Inquisitor playthrough of Star Wars: The Old Republic. Last episode was that I literally just did was for a small dungeon that I figured I'd just get out of the way. Only took 20 minutes. Nothing too intensive. And now, before we actually start, I'm going to read some mail that I've recently gotten. Alright, so the first message we got is from Madel Feth. The flame has gone out. I am ashamed to confess that I was secretly unsure releasing the flame and its rebels from Nar Shaddaa was the correct course of action. However, intelligence reports indicate he and his people have left the Huff Moon and relocated to the distant planet of Gar-Kui on the Outer Rim. The rebels appear to have traded their blasters for farming implements and founded an isolated agrarian community, to which we say, good riddance. Even Admiral Jeffan seems pleased with this resolution. He wished me to forward a small token of his appreciation for your services. May the Empire prevail. I am just all fucking on my enunciations right now, aren't I? And he gifted us with the fantastic reward of 797 credits. Wonderful. This next message is from General Colvin, Darth Revan's legacy. I have just received word from your scientists on Drummond Kos. The seed device you extracted from Darth Revan's storehouse on Nar Shaddaa appears to reconfigure nearby matter in order to grow. We speculate this ability may even one day allow it to produce separate machines of many configurations. Unfortunately, the seed's growth rate could take decades or even centuries to produce anything of use. By then, the Empire should have long since conquered every star from the unknown regions of the core. Nevertheless, this device is apparently of scientific value, and your contribution to the Empire's future has been noted for posterity. And he gifted us with 858 credits. Cool. Riley Dre, the Screaming Blade Cult. My lord, I am happy to report that your cult is positively thriving. People are still talking about that little display of power we rigged, and we're seeing a steady stream of new converts. Destrus is a natural leader, strong, willful, reassuring. Still, he can be a bit overbearing at times. Seems awfully eager to flaunt his new authority. Let's not hope he didn't pick up any bad habits from Lord Palladius. And she gave us a companion item. And that's all the messages we got. Let's see what's in the box. Oh, a vibroknife, but we can't use this. As a Sith Inquisitor, we cannot use this. get down to the planet and infiltrate this Lord's stronghold. Oh, no, wait, we already are on the planet. I have to exit the ship. Yeah, this thing is fucking huge. I'm probably gonna switch to a different mount right now. See, it obstructs the view sometimes. That's why I don't really like. I like the design and the look, I just don't like that it's so fucking big. I do like that it's mostly silent, though. Eh, why travel when it can just port there in, like, not even a few seconds? The Academy, my old stomping grounds.
Das I've no, Jumpy Signos Fraudnos, just Jumpy, right there, Jumpy.
How things have changed. How long since my master's death? By a couple hundred years at least, at least. And we gotta wait for the elevator. Wonderful. Time to do a little cleaning up the ranks here.
Thank you. Sith were above petty burglary. I wonder what your master would think if she knew you were breaking and entering. Or did she, by chance, send you on this little errand?
Of course she did.
Your mask. Zash wants it.
Zash has her own choice. What need could she have of mine? Your master and I hardly see eye to eye, but this isn't her style. Too much risk of getting caught, too little reward. That's all the marks of an apprentice. When Darth Thanaton learns of this, you will be punished.
I just... no. Maybe I should come clean.
What if I told you that I believe Zash intends to betray me, and that I need your mask to defeat her?
Already planning to kill your master? Much as I'd like to see her dead, I don't think you'll be the one.
I killed Scotia.
I've killed more powerful Sith than her.
I assume you're referring to Darth Skirtir. Trickery. Of Zash's devising, no doubt. I don't think she'll be so forthcoming about her own weaknesses. But, just for my own amusement, let's see these skills of yours. Saran, Vasek, give Zash's apprentice a proper test. Chalk after all. Darth Zash should be very proud and very afraid. The mask is just an old trinket. But if you really think it'll help you defeat her, take it.
Don't worry.
I won't fail.
See that you don't. I'd hate to have wasted such an artifact on failure.
Got the mask. Now all that's left is to talk with our master.
Apprentice, I know you are very busy, but I must speak with you. I have just had the most amazing dream, and it concerns you.
Always thinking about me.
Can't get me out of your head, can you?
In the dream, I could see the power of the Force coursing through you. Armies of Jedi rose in your path and fell before you. It's the artifact. It must be. The artifact will give you this power.
Really?
What makes you say that?
Only certain individuals, it seems, are properly attuned to the ritual the artifacts describe. I believe the remaining artifacts are on Tatooine and Alderaan. You must hurry and find them. The artifacts are the key to fulfilling your destiny.
So we got our ancestor's helmet. This I like. This will be my outfit for later in the game. But for now, I like to keep this humble outfit on for now. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, I actually thought that that this is gonna be the around the end of chapter one, but I guess not, so I guess I have to change the title. But
The first part we're going to go to is Tatooine. Oh wait, we have a conversation.
I see you've made it to Tatooine.
Oh, never mind.
Not the most luxurious destination, but trust me, the artifact is close. You'll need to find the pirate Andronikos Revel. He should be quite familiar with this piece.
Oh boy, a pirate.
I've always wanted to meet a real pirate.
Careful. Andronikos Revel's reputation, while never playful, is even less so now. He stole the artifact out of some Sith ruins, but when his crew mutinied, they took it. I sent a cruiser to recover the artifact, but all they found was Andronikos in an escape pod, half mad. We let him stew for a while in Imperial prison, and then released him. He's been hunting his crew down ever since, and we've been watching.
So he's your hound.
Does this Andronikos know you're using him to get to the artifact?
Does it matter? He gets what he wants, revenge, and you and I get what we want, the artifact. He's never lingered longer than it takes to kill, but Tatooine is different. It's been weeks. I believe Andronikos has found the leader of the mutiny, and with him, the artifact. Find Andronikos and you'll find a clear course.
Where can I find him?
Just show me where the fun is.
I don't know precisely. Andronikos must have come through the spaceport at some point. Start with the shipmaster. Good luck, apprentice. And remember, every piece draws you closer to your full potential.
All right, and now let's talk to Kim.
Warpine's brigand is
my master. Do not mock the cruelty of my fate. Please leave me into my peace.
I'm sorry you're upset. Mind telling me why?
In I aft one
after our last conversation, I began to wonder what came of
our rival and our
like. Veshik Urk. This is how I found this, a Jedi record of a stasis chamber they uncovered, like the one you found me in. They say the creature inside was killed.
It can't be easy waking up and finding all your friends dead.
Zikleka,
I do not need sympathy from you, little Sith. If I was free, I would hunt those Jedi relentlessly and feast on my revenge. As it is, my only choice is to laugh at my own powerlessness. Ha! I mean, if you wanted to, I could send you out and you could go and do your thing, man, but you want to be a little asshole about it. Actually, hold on. Since we're gonna be trekking through the deserts, it's only fitting that I have an animal to guide me through the desert.
Take a look at the stock. What can I get you?
You have nothing.
Appreciate your business.
Well, there's the guy.
Have you heard of a pirate named Andronikos Revel?
want the humpa.
Pirate? Nah, I don't consult with those types. Bad for business. Tatooine's not much of a place, but it's best to keep your nose clean anyway. Wrong.
Consider that I am Sith, and answer again.
Well, I guess I knew that. Wasn't going to say anything. In that case, I guess I have seen this under my surveil after all. But you don't want anything to do with that guy, believe me. I'll be the judge of that.
That's hardly your call.
Okay, I hear he shows up every now and again. You can't get it in most Ewa. But I'm warning you, the guy's crazy. Don't talk to nobody. Don't drink anything stronger than water. The only reason Rig, the Cantina owner, don't kick Antonio is because he's scared to death of him. But you didn't hear it from me. Okay. And this is the story arc for Tatooine.
My lord, welcome to Tatooine. If you hold a moment, I can provide directions to the research center.
Research center?
I wasn't aware of any research center.
Sorry, my error. Much of the Imperial traffic we get is assigned to the archaeological expedition. Security, scientific equipment. They don't tell me what it's for. If you're going to be here long, you might wish to consult with Captain Gola. We wouldn't want to interfere with Sith activity.
Thank you.
I appreciate the help.
These are the center's coordinates. I'll alert them that you may be coming.
Modais Akran Bairanans Jawan Jandans Imban Gudis.
The heat does not trouble me. Keep cool on this world, little Sith. Okay, I actually want your guys' opinion on this. Which should I go with for this planet? The Raptor? Or this thing? Because I on this planet, I want to use animals instead of speeders, so what do you think is best? This thing or the Raptor? I like the colors on this thing. They're both the same. They have the same speed, it's just looks. So they both go the same speed. Okay, I'll go with the big one then. Oh, and there's a quest over here too.
My lord, I'm sorry for whatever business brings you to this worthless wasteland. You interested in striking a blow against the exchange? Sooner the Empire tightens the noose, the sooner most of us can ship home. Gangsters are smuggling our explosives out of Mos Ila, selling them to the Republic. We need to show them it's a bad idea.
They need to be taught a lesson.
No one steals from the Empire and lives.
Thank you, my lord. We need our explosives back, and we need to find out who's running their operation. If you'll help, I'll get you locations for all suspected stashes. But be careful. We've already lost good soldiers to the exchange guards.
They won't be a problem.
I'll fight the whole galaxy if I have to.
If any of their men attack, search them. They must have a base, a way to communicate. Retrieving the explosives is important, but we must get to their leaders to stop this problem for good.
So close to selling those things.
Keela, I need those water readings. We won't get more supplies without a report.
Sorry, sir. I'll check as soon as I can. Sand in the gauges.
Blast. Bring in some local technicians. See if they can fix us up while I greet our guests. My lord, Baron Gola, Imperial Reclamation Service. I've run excavations on Zeost, Malachor II, and Nimdrovus. But add a little heat and dust, and we've got nothing but trouble.
I was told to come here.
Your man at the spaceport said this was a research center.
Not exactly up to standard, but yes, Mos Eila is our base of operations.
Why, Captain, you should have alerted me. You know I enjoy guests. Captain Golar and his crew report to me. I am Darth Silthar. They are my hands, digging and scraping where I cannot. We came to Tatooine to solve a mystery, one of dead men and desert secrets. Not for conquest, but for power.
I came for a secret, too.
I hope we're not in competition, my lord.
Oh, I very much doubt it. But let us talk, one Sith to another. The Empire recently found a damaged shuttle drifting through deep space. It came from a Zerka Corporation research base on Tatooine.
Zerka had Tatooinean artifacts they claimed were the find of the millennium. Mystery devices with the energy throughput of a sun. But a month after the shuttle launch, their research base disappeared. Zerka never came back.
Somewhere in this wasteland is power enough to destroy a world, remake a galaxy. My team is going to find the Zerka base and these artifacts along with it. We will learn their secrets. Will you join us?
Tell me more about Zerka.
Fools who believe that research and technology are a match for true power. They will not interfere. Now, scattered across the desert, sheltered within caves, live a people called the Sons of Palawa. They are an exacting and ritualistic tribe, come to Tatooine to test themselves against the elements. A settlement nearby has something we need.
Test themselves?
Test themselves how?
They pound their fists into sand, drill for water instead of using vaporators, what you'd expect.
Most importantly, the Sons of Palawa possess a clue to Zerka's fate. What did you call them, Captain?
Experimental battle droids, armed with turbo lasers, shields, and who knows what else.
Zerka droids, no doubt rebuilt by the Sons of Palawa. And the tribals are not inclined to share.
All right.
Look no further. I am your Sith.
After the Empire took Mos Eila, the Sons of Palawa decided we were invaders. They'll shoot anyone who gets close.
But why should that stop you? If the droids truly are from Zerka, I want their secrets. Dissect them, peel the droids' armor, and bring the captain their Verber brains. Then they will lead us to the missing Zerka base.
That dude is very, how do I put this? He has the feeling of, like, I'm your friend, but also I'm gonna stab you in the back at some point. You know what I mean?
Amagas Kapana. Morpan, Himinam Arpai Bohavnona.
I have an excellent Sabacc face. That was a joke. I hate Sabacc. You only have three claws, so how can you even hold the cards right?
I'm looking for a pirate named Andronicus Revel.
Look, even if I knew him, I wouldn't tell you where he is. Customers don't like bartenders to blab. Not that I listen anyway. Look, Sith, this is a peaceful establishment. We don't want any trouble, so buy a drink, enjoy yourself, but don't start anything. That's really up to you.
I won't start anything if you tell me what I want to know.
You're not going to let things go, are you? Last time, Sith, I don't know the fella. Never heard of him. Now, is there anything else I can do for you, or can I get some peace? This is your last warning.
You better not be lying to me.
On my grandmother's grave, it's true, I don't know any Andronicus. You want to fight him? Try talking to that no-good worthless dancer. Spends more time flirting than dancing and more time yapping than either. I bet she's seen him. That was certainly a long pause.
Reg says you know Andronicus Revel.
Huh, I hate to break to you, sweetie, but Reg lied to his own grandmother. Him's the one that's been doing business with Andronicus. I've never seen the guy in my life. But for a price, until you gotta get over it, give up any information you want. Huh? Why were you dancing on a table with no one in the room? Were you just practicing? What was that? Let's make a deal.
You tell me how to get Reg to talk, and I won't kill you.
All right, no need to get all crazy-eyed. Take this bottle to Red. It's Somonsko Red, a rare drink. It costs a small fortune, so you can't blame me for trying to make the money back, right? Oh, you are on my shit list, little alien man.
This bottle has your name on it. If you tell me where to find a certain pirate.
Where did you find that? That's the finest of the... Oh, no. You don't understand, Sith. Andronicus Revel doesn't want to be found. Nobody's gonna find him. He'll kill me if I tell, or worse. You know what? You're pissing me off, so... Deal with the consequences, friend.
It's either that, or this.
Blasted Sith, fine. Give me the red and don't ever do that to me again. It might get my intestines ripped out of the middle of the night, but I can't stand pain. Wonderful.
This Andronicus fellow is sounding better and better.
Andronicus keeps a room upstairs. He likes his privacy. He paid me not to let on he's here. Of course, it helps at the time he caught someone telling him onto one of the exchange gang. He blew both of their brains out. Bug him out at your own risk. But if he's up in his room, it usually means he doesn't want to be bothered. I will try to negotiate and be as good as I can be, but that guy was pissing me off so bad, I had to fucking just zap him. I like the sound he made. I like the little gurgle he did.
I believe you have the artifact I'm looking for.
Webb, folks aren't supposed to know I'm here.
I'm sorry, Andronicus. It was that damn bartender.
Take care of it. Now, Sith, your artifact. I don't have it, and I'm glad. Thing drove my crew insane. They mutinied. I floated 10 days in a disabled escape pod and spent 30 more in Imperial lockup on account of that hunk of rock.
The artifact did it?
Convenient excuse for failure.
Kipun pate sa east
beans. The artifact belonged to my master, Little Sith. Do not underestimate what they can do.
I know what I saw, Sith. But I won't stop you from going after that rock if you want it. The guy who has your artifact is the guy I'm on Tatooine to kill. Silas Wilkes. My old first mate. He started the mutiny, then tossed me into space. Now he's an exchange big shot. He's got your Sith toy.
We should work together.
Perhaps a partnership is in order.
Glad you see it that way. It'll take both of us to get Wilkes. I've been chasing Wilkes halfway across the galaxy. Stole my favorite blasters, not to mention my pride. Lucky thing I got a contact inside the exchange. Only I can't exactly just stroll into the exchange base.
Who is this contact?
Andronicus Ravel has his own personal spy network.
It ain't quite like that. Contact's name is Casey Ricks, old friend who used to be part of my crew. But she, doesn't exactly know I'm here. She's sure to know where Wilkes is hiding. Tell her you know me, and she'll tell you everything.
I'll do it.
Consider it done.
You get that information, you can do what you want with it. But I'd appreciate it if you came back here first. Me and Wilkes are long overdue for a talk.
Yeah, that was very nice to do. Oh god, that fucking bartender was a dick. I'm glad I zapped him. This thing out. I'm curious to see what it does.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. Yeah, I'll go with this. This feels like it's worth it more. Since I'm here, I might as well go over to that area to get the rest of the components I need. Oh, thanks for the follow. God, I'm honestly starting to remember why I like Tatooine for its aesthetic and for obvious other reasons because of the movies, but God, is it a fucking maze sometimes in some areas? This one, to be exact. What's the achievement? Worm food? Sure, how do I get it? Jump into the Sarlacc pit. Oh god. You know what? Sure. If I can find while I'm out there exploring, if I see it, I'll find it. Or do you have the exact coordinates to it? I'll go fucking do it right now. I can just fast travel to this place later. So it is a title and an achievement. Alright. Interesting. Alright, those guys are dead now. I guess I'll go out into the dunes and find that Sarlacc pit then. way, I could just fast travel to the at least the area I need to go to.
At your service, my lord. Travel route is confirmed.
From the center of the map, it's due north. Oh, okay, so I looked up the thing on my phone, and it's the area I need to go is the Dune Sea right here, so I'll just get off on this next fast travel point and head over there.
Displaying all authorized destinations.
I'll say this much, despite my feelings on this quest line in particular, this area certainly is atmospheric, I'll say that much. Nah, you're cool, man. Alright, almost there. So I need to go straight for like a good chunk of time. I'm gonna start the Eternal Throne story tomorrow. I'm so not looking forward to it. Why is that? You've done it too much, or is it because of the slow beginning? Usually my issue with starting that whole thing is I'm always impatient to start it, so whenever I get the option of, hey, do you want to skip all this story to go do it, I did yes, and then unfortunately I didn't realize that by missing out on some of the story, I missed out on a bunch of achievements and shit, and I saw that one of those achievements gave you a mount, and I was pretty pissed when I found that out. Hold on. Why is the shadow like that? Look at the mount's shadow right there. I'm pretty sure that's not how shadows work, but whatever, game. Okay. It is long, drawn out, and needlessly extended. Yeah. Because reasons, it is a feature working perfectly as intended. Yep, totally. But yeah, I can see that. Whenever I did it for the first time, God, wasn't it like 10 whole chapters until you could get to like the Alliance base or whatever? But yeah, of course, that's not how shadows work. We're almost there. I'm pretty sure that's not it. From what I saw, it's supposed to be a bit farther ahead. Nine to ten, yeah. No, not too. but yeah, too drawn out and in some cases really bloody stupid. I'm trying to remember which chapters I didn't like. The one that I'd probably say is when you were helping out Kaleo, that was a bit fucking out there that I felt didn't need to be there. Alright, we're at the pit. And look at all these fucking Gamorreans. Alright, time to jump in there. Son of a bitch. Hold on, I can just call a medical probe. I executed her every time. I mean, Kaleo's not annoying, but goddamn, is she... Her quest is really long. I feel unnecessary. You received this title after being devoured by the Sarlacc creature on Tatooine. God, look at that image. Alright, now back to the main story.
Please use all products only as intended.
I want to say I've done this before, because only a codex entry popped up. I might have gotten I got the title, but no achievement popped up, so it might have been something I did before. Alright, but let's go out this way. The Datacrons I'm going to be doing off stream since, from what I looked up, some on some planets are really, intricate, like the Sith fleet one where you have to go to get a bunch of different items and then get a bunch of different people to go and activate some stuff. That's not something I'm going to be doing, at least on my own. So most of these I'm doing off stream. So we gotta go in that house.
Casey Ricks. Andronicus sent me. He said you know where to find Silas Wilkes.
Andronicus? You mean he's out of prison? He doing all right? And he's after Wilkes, figures. Andronikos doesn't really forgive or forget. Hey, you're not planning to harm him, are you?
Ah, 45 minutes. That's a ride I have to take? What do you mean by that?
It won't be your fault if something happens to him.
I guess that's the best I'm gonna get from you, huh? I'll tell you where to find that son of a hut. In fact, I'll make sure he's there so you can kill him. Wilkes's base is hidden out of Aether's view. Andronikos will know what I mean.
Got it.
Out of Aether's view. I think I can remember that.
Good. Let me call Wilkes. Make sure he stays put. It'd be a shame for you to storm HQ while he's out.
No tricky business now.
Don't do anything you'll regret.
Like warn Wilkes? We both know that'd be suicide.
Casey, sweetheart. Got something to report? Andronikos hasn't turned up, has he?
Oh, sigh. What do I have to do to make you stop worrying about Andronikos?
Well, I could think of a few things. Have you reconsidered my offer?
That's why I called. Are you free in, say, a couple of hours? We could talk about it. In person.
I always have time for you. I'll be right here, sweetheart, whenever you're ready.
Ugh, I hate that guy. Andronikos never went for that eyelash batting junk, but Wilkes is there. So hurry up and kill him.
I hope that was fake.
I mean, you aren't really...
No! I've been able to string him along so far without it. But I won't shed any tears when he's gone, to say the least.
Alright, now to fast travel to the cantina. That bartender better be fucking dead, by the way. Yeah, that bartender better be dead by the time I get in there.
Tell Reg I can't have any more slip-ups. Wilkes finds out I'm here, it'll be like Rusan all over again.
Oh, he's still alive.
Yes, Andronikos. Whatever you say.
Go. About time, Sith. This room's feeling a lot like that escape pod. Make me happy. Tell me you found Wilkes.
She gave me a cryptic message.
Casey said Wilkes was out of Aether's view.
Out of Aether's view, huh? Spineless son of a hut is hiding underground.
Makes sense.
Smart place to hide.
I should have thought of it myself. There's a system of caves on the other side of the abandoned farm settlement. I wager that's what Casey meant.
Let's get moving.
Why aren't you shooting already?
Hey, I always want to shoot something, but the old girl encrypted something on this data pad. Looks like it's an access code. Something we'll need to get into this hidden HQ, probably.
Bring it along.
Looks like it could come in handy.
I'm gonna blast Wilkes for every day I spent floating in that escape pod. And then I'm gonna stomp on his bones.
My master, what is this?
Would you have had him Kemball serving up the Great Tula Cord for some weak human? This is only temporary, relax.
I need him to find the artifact.
Be wary.
I will not easily be
broken.
Breaking up is so hard.
I'm sorry, Ken. We just weren't meant to be.
I'll be waiting on the ship then, Master. God, such a whiny baby, I swear. And we got our second companion. The pirate Andronikos Ravel.
You okay?
Oh. That, guess I couldn't sell anything to that vendor.
This is really great.
Just giving him some of this shit so I can clear out his face.
Thanks.
Your smuggling ring is broken. Here's everything I could salvage.
Excellent. I was hoping that was you I was hearing about. The local authorities have been all in a dither about an unprovoked massacre of suspected exchange members. I hope this compensates you sufficiently for your time.
But I'd lost you there.
There we go. All right, now to travel to our location. Oh, I can't find anything. Almost to the fast travel station, then I can just fly on over there.
You won't find a better bargain.
Oh, is there anything here I don't have? No. I'll deal with. No, wait. I need to sell my shit.
Come back anytime.
Displaying all authorized destinations.
I feel so silly knowing I could have just fast traveled there instead of taking the speeder. Right, that way to Wilkes' base. Those womp rats sounded like lions for a minute. They should not have sounded like that. Yeah, your size does not match your voice, friend.
Shooting.
Wait, am I even going the right way? It kinda looks like it, but I'm not sure. Close.
Do it. I have too much overhead to close shop now.
I'm almost there.
Blast Wilkes to pieces just as soon as we find him.
There you are, you motherfucker.
Well, well, Andronicus Revel, I'm surprised they let you out of Imperial prison. And you brought a Sith to help you. How cute. But see these guys? They'll crush you and your Sith.
Cute?
I'm not cute. I'm deadly.
Let me guess. You're here for the artifact. The one the Empire was so keen on getting just before I crushed Andronicus. Would you believe he called me a nobody? A worthless, mangy, skinny little nobody? So I took his ship, his crew, his cargo, his blasters, and what else? Oh, his girl. Who's nobody now, Nikki?
I'm gonna rip out your throat and laugh while you try to scream.
Less talk, more killing.
All of this chatter is making me bloodthirsty.
You'll never beat me, and you'll never get your artifact. Boys, kill the Sith, but keep Andronicus alive. I'll want to play with him a little longer.
These are very confident. Motherfucker, I am the main character.
You idiots! You'll never get it now. Not the artifact, not the blasters, nothing.
Enough of your secrets.
We beat you. Now tell us where they are.
You're so stupid. The great Andronicus Revel chases me across 5 planets, only to fail. Even gets a Sith on his side, and they both fail.
Talk sense.
The artifact. It's cursed. It's cursed.
Yeah, I figured that one out.
They took it, just like I took it from you. Took it all. The blasters, the artifact, the money.
Enough.
Tell us where they took it.
Chase them if you like. They went out into the deep desert. They left weeks ago. The sand people will eat you before you ever catch them.
I've heard enough. Now give me one good reason not to blast your teeth through the back of your skull.
Yes, please kill him.
Do it. Maybe he'll finally shut up.
I've been waiting to do this for a long time, Wilkes. Can't say it was nice knowing you either.
I have no regrets, Andronicus. Least of all this.
Idiot. Lost your artifact and my special-made blasters. Just wait until I get my blaster pointed at those thieves.
You think they've gone far?
Exactly how deep into the desert do we have to go?
Well, there's a speeder that'll take us out so far, but the coordinates Wilkes had are a little further out than that. Come on, the sooner we get out there, the better chance we have of showing them thieves what's what.
Alright, travel to this base, and then we'll fast travel from there for the speeder.
At your service, my lord. Travel route is confirmed.
I've already been there.
Hello. That's right. I'm talking to you. I know who you are, and I bring a proposal. I'm Jael Tasau. I speak for a small consortium of the Exchange on Tatooine. They want a warlord dead, and they think you're the one to do it.
Who's the person?
Let's start with a name.
The target is the warlord Garbodia. He killed a Sith apprentice sent to assassinate him. And it's costing all of us. Imperials are torturing and killing Exchange members to find his location. Now, I know where Gar is, but I came to you. Understand why?
Where is he?
I understand. I suggest you tell me his location.
Gar and his mercenaries are hiding in the desert. I saw them taking shade by a derelict sandcrawler. We can pay for his head. That ugly bantha stain is done. The Empire agrees, the Exchange agrees. How about you?
I will not be kind to him.
He will know suffering far worse than he has caused.
Good. Now, he does move around a lot. Don't expect to find him exactly at the Sandcrawler. You bring me his head, and I'll bring you the credits.
Hey, what do you know? All this is pretty close by.
Between the eyes. I love this.
Been in the desert 3 days now. About midday, the day we left, Narek tried to turn back, but Hayes, we had none of it. We couldn't have Narek telling Wilkes. We forced Narek to continue at gunpoint, and at nightfall, we got all together to talk about what to do about Narek. Hayes wanted to shoot him, but Hayes wanted to shoot everybody, but then the Sand People attacked and took care of Narek for us. Ever since that first night, we've kept a watch to warn us if the Sand People attack. Not that it does any good without the lights from town. You can't see anything in the desert at night. Tomorrow, if we're still alive, we plan to head north.
According to this datapad, the thieves... How's this for shooting?
Thank you.
I might as well go this direction and finish off that warlord guy. What the hell is that in the sky? They look kind of like birds, but it's hard to tell. Got a little too overconfident. Maybe I should switch him to be a healer so I can survive more. Got his head, but now to the main mission. They don't seem to be getting any closer either, they just seem more and more far away. This guy seems to be alone. Might as well kill him just in case there's anything tied to achievements here.
How's this for shooting?
It was kind of out of the way. It wasn't really out of the way, so nothing really lost there.
Shooting.
First Nerik, then Jock, then Haze, no board. I don't think I can take it anymore. I really think Paul is trying to kill me. He said it was the sand people who got Haze and Jock, but he's lying. I can tell. He killed them while they slept. Haze because he had the artifact. Jack because he had accused Paul of killing Haze. If it hadn't been for the sand people kill Ford and Nerik with my own eyes, I think it was all Paul. I just hope he doesn't find this or I'm next. We plan to head east in the morning. I hope I live to see it.
This datapad says the thieves went this way. It can't be much further.
Yep, more traveling. Or wait, hold on a second. Maybe this will be a bit faster. It's not much, but hey, I figured might as well. After some sales go through, I'll have enough credits to afford all the upgrades for speed. It's all over now. Paul's gone raving mad. He accused Beckus of trying to kill him, at least at the last campsite, and shot him. We were already deep into Sand People territory at the time, so the blaster shot drew all kinds of unwanted attention. Those beasts had us on the run for 3 days. Out of the 15 of us that started, there's only me and Paul left. Now Paul's talking about taking the artifact to the Sand People's camp to the north as a peace offering. I tried to tell him there's no way we'll walk away from those beast camp alive, but he wouldn't listen.
Stay sharp, Sith. The thieves ran right into the beast's mouth. The Sand People camps.
I'd
idiotic, nerve-hurting sons of huts. They got away.
Not exactly.
They were killed and possibly eaten. There's a difference.
What? It doesn't bother you? These idiots run off with your artifact and you don't even get to knock them around? I just can't figure you, Sith.
They got what they had coming to them.
It's enough to know that they suffered.
For you, maybe. I was looking forward to shooting the eyeballs out of their skulls. But you're the boss, huh, Sith? Now, are we gonna get off this rock or what?
Soon.
I still have business to finish here.
Well, when you do fly, mind taking me along? I'm a damn good pilot, and I've got contacts a Sith will never make on his own. It'll be your show, no questions asked.
If you insist.
You have no intention of letting this drop, do you?
Well, then let's get off this rock, huh?
So, this is what I'm planning to do right now. Give me 1 second to turn in this quest right here.
My people say someone ripped through Garbodia's camp. Can I spot Talon or what? I trust you if I knew his head was gonna stink this badly, I'd have given you a refrigeration unit. Thanks. You can wrap that back up. Oof.
This is your evidence. Whether it drips or not.
Ugh. One more thing the guys in the cells will owe me for. They're gonna be cleaning my Bantha Ranch. Nasty as this is, it's better than what was going on before. I just couldn't personally smell it. Do you see a garbage chute?
Okay, yeah, so I'm going to end the stream soon, and I will continue on with the planet quest line in the next episode. But not before going to my ship to turn in the class quest. Oh, wait. The hangar. Never mind. Hold on. So, I'm not leaving just yet.
So you beat Wilkes and made it out of the desert alive, huh? Wilkes doesn't surprise me, but when I heard you were heading for the desert, well, I wasn't expecting to see either of you again.
Give the guy some credit.
Andronicus turned out to be an okay fighter after all.
Better than okay, huh? I got my share of them sand people.
Wasn't meant as an insult. There's lots of stuff in that desert that can't be fought, and it's just as deadly. Anyway, I'm glad you came, because it gives me a chance to thank you for taking out that runt, Wilkes. With some real leadership, maybe the exchange on Tatooine can move ahead for a change.
Have fun.
Good luck with that.
Thanks. I'm hopeful. And Andronicus, I'm sorry.
It's all right, huh? We wouldn't have worked out anyway. All that shouting and throwing stuff, somebody was bound to get hurt.
Yeah, right. Well, guess it's goodbye then. Good luck out there.
I'm confused.
What was all that about?
Nothing. Just saying goodbye is all. Let's get off this rock, huh?
Alright, so once we got on the ship and use the holo terminal, that's gonna be the end. And then we'll do Tatooine Part 2 next time.
Alright, come on. There we go.
Apprentice, you have recovered the artifact, I take it. Wonderful. Ah, Andronikos, what a pleasure to see you again.
Hello yourself. Looks like you finally found your rock.
Yes, thank you for leading us to it so obligingly. I'm sure you'll be a wonderful asset to my apprentice's crew. Now, apprentice, you must hurry and recover the remaining artifact.
This should be fine.
I'm giddy with anticipation.
I look forward to seeing you in your glory.
And we have some conversation that you can do. So let's do that before we go and end the stream.
Pistana Fotu Peinana,
Ja and Hofjans. Remember I told you about Morten Sella, my master's apprentice, and is the Shad's slave.
Ute Pata, Kipano I Alai Swerana.
Varishork lives, that my mistress' death does not yet claim him. What makes you so certain?
How did you discover this?
Ak Usu Tondin Manan Jai Lugen Avojanin.
The place was a vault on Tatooine.
Swaywai Silvans in Iswish Paman Ik Alkas Jam Widis in Tis Iswaris.
In my life before it took this cruel turn.
We must get to Tatooine.
Ni Pate Uvaro is Sandan Sware Kanidede Ak Jaswaluda Is.
Oh. So, this is, what his companion questline. We get to find his long-lost friend on Tatooine. But before, so that's also another thing to look forward to next episode. But let's talk to Andronikos for now.
So what's the story, Sith? Seems like you know all about me, and I don't know nothing about you. You always the squeaky clean, or you making up for something?
I was a convicted criminal.
Some Imperial thought it would be funny to shoot my kind for sport. I shot back. They wanted to kill me, but made me Sith instead.
Funny how those Sith work. I was an accountant on Moneyland when I decided I wanted a little more adventure. So I put a blaster to the head of the intergalactic banking clan and walked off with a few million credits. Been robbing and murdering ever since.
You lie.
I don't for one moment believe you were an accountant.
Well, how's this for accounting? In 3 years, the Sky Princess took more cargo and harassed more Republic ships than half the Imperial fleet. I'm a liar and a thief and a murderer, but I'm good. You know, you got a pretty nice ship. It's no Sky Princess, but hey, what is? I had a ship like it once. No armor to speak of, but you don't need defense when you can maneuver like that.
What happened to it?
You didn't seem to have a ship when I met you.
Yeah, got blown to pieces. But it was a thrill while it lasted. Nothing like playing chicken with a ship twice your size and then firing up his tail when he blinks. Sky Princess was great, but she couldn't do that.
Will you be my pilot?
Would you like to fly the ship?
How do you Sith say it? My lord, it would be an honor. You just tell me where you want to go.
Groovy, so our new friend is also the pilot of the ship now. So I don't have to unnecessarily fly it everywhere now.
Hey, you got time to chat?
Sure.
Sure. Did you have something in mind?
No, just wondering. Haven't been aboard too long. Like to know who I'm working with. Nothing touchy-feely, just enough to know you got my back.
Help me, and I'll help you.
You get my back, I'll get yours. Simple as that.
We see eye to eye. Just one more thing. You ever butt heads with the Republic, let me have a shot. I got a score to settle, and it'll be a long time before I call it even.
Damn, there is a lot of conversations you can have with them.
You hear that, Sith? Nothing like it in the galaxy. The hum of an idling blaster. Potential energy right there. It's like waking up on your birthday wondering what you got. For a few minutes, it's anything. The whole galaxy, just waiting for you to pull the trigger.
Does it have a name?
What do you call it?
Nah, don't name my blasters. It's a bad idea to get attached. Actually, I was wondering. These blasters are nice, but a pirate's only as good as his equipment. We don't got fancy force powers like you Sith.
Here you go.
I think I have a spare set here, if that's what you're asking for.
I'll pay it back, Sith. Don't worry. Thanks.
God damn, even more? I expected this to be over long ago, holy shit. Okay, let's keep going, I guess. Maybe this is the last one, but I'm honestly kind of hoping it's not.
You know, I think I heard the ship's engine making a strange noise earlier. Mind if I check it out sometime?
You're pretty smart.
I didn't know you knew anything about engines.
Yeah, I've lived on ships most of my life. You don't do that without picking up something. I'm no expert, but a buddy of mine back before the war taught me most of what I know. Carl Norn, best technician I knew. Worst card player. Could never see when the deck was stacked against him. And it always was.
Why was my character looking around hella nervously for a second? That was weird. How did you know him?
Was this one of your pirate friends?
My old man ran a shop on one of those planets people only visit if they break down or if they're running from something. Carl stumbled in on a tin can held together by sheer willpower, well, and the skills of the best mechanic in the galaxy. Made me first mate after the war, on a ship called the Bloodshot Ranker. I learned a lot before he gambled the ship away. But you're sick of hearing me jabber, huh?
Still more conversations? Holy fuck, man.
Engine's fixed. Looks like we took on some rock on one of our last jumps. Nothing big. Reminds me of the time I took the Sky Princess through an asteroid field. My ship mechanics were furious. Clean rock out of our engines for weeks. Had to replace one of the rears, it was so badly damaged.
An asteroid field?
What were you doing in an asteroid field?
Dodging the enforcers. When you got a fleet of Republic ships on your tail, you take whatever cover you can find. Rocks don't have cannons. Besides, what's life without a little risk, huh? That's why I became a pirate. The risk, the reward, the freedom.
Sounds fun.
Perhaps I should take up piracy then. The Sith have too many rules.
I think you'd be one of the best. Galaxy's only Sith pirate.
Holy fucking shit, there's still more. Oh my god. I'm liking this. I'm really liking this, let's just say that. I'll say that much.
So what does a Sith do for fun?
Sith things.
Oh, the usual. Lying, killing, manipulating. Sith is more of a lifestyle.
At least you have a sense of humor about it, huh?
Wow, that was it? Okay, that one was disappointing.
Need something?
How are you doing?
Just checking in on my favorite pirate.
Hey, I'm flying with the craziest son of a hut in the galaxy. No complaints here.
So, I'm hoping that's not the end of talking with him, because I do want to learn more, but I know for a fact that if you're a female Sith Inquisitor, he's your romance option, if you want to romance one of your companions, and I think he gets more into his backstory if you romance him as a woman. But I've never played a woman character, so I wouldn't know. Maybe. Alright, and that's probably, hopefully, the end. I'm going to be doing some stuff off-stream. Nothing really big, mostly just selling some things on the market and hoping they take. But I would like to thank you all for coming to the stream. It's
been a lot more lively than I thought it would be, and a lot more exciting than I thought it was going to be, too. Next episode will be Tatooine Part 2 and some stuff for Kim Vol on Tatooine, so it'll be loads of fun. I would also like to thank my number one fan for always watching these. It means so, so much for me to have you be there, and hopefully pretty soon we can have some good times together. Alright, but until the next episode, I have been King Kuma, and I'd like you all to have a good day, good night, or, you know, whatever. And until then, you all take care. Goodbye.